Hello friends, today in this video I am going to discuss about the DNA cloning with plasmid vector. At first we have to know about the DNA cloning. What is DNA cloning? DNA cloning is a technique which is used to produce large amount of identical DNAs from a single DNA fragment or a single gene of interest. Okay, now suppose. This is a genomic DNA, okay, and here a gene is present known as gene A. This gene A is our gene of interest. Okay, now we want to clone this gene A from this whole genomic DNA. Okay, so now we have to cut this gene A from this whole genomic DNA, and this is done by the restriction enzymes. Now, what is restriction enzyme? Restriction enzyme is a particular endonuclease enzyme which cut the DNA at a particular restriction site. Okay, and the restriction site is of 4 to 6 base pair sequence of inverted repeat where the restriction enzyme cut the DNA. Now suppose, for example, EcoR1, which is a restriction enzyme, recognize a 6 base pair restriction site. This is a 5 prime GAATTC 3 prime. Okay, 5 prime GAATTC 3 prime. Okay, now EcoR1, that is a restriction enzyme, recognize this particular inverted repeat sequence from a DNA inverted repeat sequence. Okay, now this two DNA strands are same when we read this sequence from the 5 prime end. Okay, now this is 5 prime GAATTC and 5 prime GAATTC. So this particular DNA sequence is known as inverted repeat because they are same in both strand when we read the DNA strand from the 5 prime ends. Okay, now EcoR1 cut this sequence, recognize this particular recognition site and cut it from this and this position. Okay, and produce a sticky end like this. 5 prime GAATTC 3 prime and 5 prime produce this sticky end. And suppose this particular EcoR1 recognition site present in this two position of gene A. Okay, now when we add this EcoR1 to this genome, it particularly cut the gene of interest, that is a gene A, in this EcoR1 site and produce a sticky end fragment of gene A like this. Okay, produce, and this is the gene A. Okay, now to clone this gene A, we have to ligate this gene A to a plasmid vector. Okay, Now I will discuss about the plasmid vector. At first, we have to know about the plasmid. Plasmid is an autonomously replicating closed circular extra chromosomal DNA that is different from the bacteria's own chromosome. Okay, now for DNA cloning, we basically used a plasmid vector which must contain three regions. That is the origin region, which is required to initiate plasmid, which is required to initiate replication in the plasmid vector autonomously. And the second is the polylinker or multiple cloning site. This site contain multiple restriction site where a particular restriction enzyme cut the plasmid vector, and then we can ligate gene of interest to the plasmid vector, and then we can transform this plasmid vector to the host cell. Okay, now the selectable marker. A selectable marker is used to select this plasmid vector containing host cell. Okay, for this example, AMPR, that is the amphicillin resistance gene, act as a selectable marker. Suppose this is a media containing amphicillin. Okay, now in this media only those host cell will survive that contain this plasmid vector containing amphicillin resistance gene. Now to start the DNA cloning process, we at first have to cut the plasmid vector in the polylinker region by the same restriction enzyme which is used to cut the gene of interest, that is the gene A. So as we use the EcoR1 as a restriction enzyme to cut the gene of interest, here we have to cut the plasmid vector with the EcoR1 so that they can produce same sticky end and they can integrate to each other. Okay, now it is cut with the EcoR1 and it produces a sticky end like this, GCTTAA. Okay, now if we add this gene of interest, it will bind to it, A. Okay, now here we add the DNA ligase. DNA ligase will create a phosphodiester bond between the 5' OH group in the A and 5' phosphate group in this A, adenine, and OH group in the G, and produce a phosphodiester bond. Now this is known as recombinant plasmid vector which contain the gene of interest, and it is called recombinant DNA because it contain two different fragments of DNA that comes from different source. Okay, now we have to transform this recombinant plasmid vector to the host cell like E. coli. Okay, now to transform this recombinant plasmid vector to the host cell like E. coli, at first we have to make the cell competent so that the bacterial cell can uptake this recombinant plasmid vector. Okay, at first to make the cell competent, we have to add calcium chloride. At first mix the plasmid vector to the E. coli cell mixed with E. coli cells and then add calcium chloride and give a heat shock so that the cell is competent to take the recombinant plasmid vector. And now this is the E. coli cell and it is its bacterial chromosome, E. coli chromosome, and the plasmid recombinant vector is entered into the bacterial cell. Okay, now this plasmid vector is replicated autonomously and produce many plasmid vector containing the gene of interest. Okay, and now we have to grow these bacterial cells in a medium containing ampicillin so that only those bacteria which uptake this recombinant plasmid vector containing ampicillin resistance gene will grow in the ampicillin medium and give colony. Okay, and each colony comes from the single transformed cell. Okay, and each colony has many clone of gene of interest containing the plasmid vector containing gene of interest. Okay, now after that we can isolate and purify the gene of interest from the plasmid vector, which is our main motto. Okay, now this is the whole process of DNA cloning. Okay, thank you for watching this video.